my children and me and the grandfather paint designs on a newspaper, and then we use it for wrapping presents. Let me show you. Look on the screen. You'll see it.
On newspaper?
Yeah, right on newspaper.
My brother and I push a couple of tables together and paint designs on the newspaper. The idea is not to take too long doing any one of them. The dye sinks right into the newspaper and you can go over it almost right away. Just make it up as you go along. If one idea doesn't work out right, try another. The grown-ups come in to watch. Before you know it, they're trying their hand at it, too. No two people make the same kind of design. Some want to paint actual pictures, but I think this takes too long. It's better just to use your imagination. Uh-oh. Someone else wants to get in on the act. Well, she can if she wants. We just don't give her the best brushes, because she sometimes pushes them. Actually, any age can have fun with this. As I was saying, no two people are alike. Some like stripes, some like dots, some like, she doesn't know it, but we give her jars filled with vegetable coloring.
Hey, that's pretty.
One of the best.
Let me show you. This is the kind of brushes we use. Any kind of floppy brush.
But I want to know what kind of paint they're using.
That's important. You don't use poster paint. You use some kind of ink or dye. You can buy it at an art store in a little package of powder, and you pour it into a glass and stir it around. Sometimes add a little vinegar to it to make its colors bright.
Not for the little ones.
Oh, well, for the little ones, we used vegetable coloring because the aniline dye, I don't know, I don't think it's poisonous, but it wouldn't be good to drink it. But the whole idea is you can have so much fun at it. You can make any plaids. Some people make plaids. Oh. It's a pity this isn't color because these are all bright yellow, blue, greens. I can usually recognize which in the family has done every one, whether it's a daughter or her grandfather.
Well, who did this one? Who did this one?
This is her grandfather. This is the 10-year-old. This is me. And this is me. This is her. Oh, this is me. And, you figure it's destined for the garbage can anyway, and so you don't need to be self-conscious. You just fool around and have...
Oh, that's a beauty.
Yeah.
Who's that?
That's my daughter. Oh. She's 10 years old now. This is an interesting one because, it starts off by making an ink blot. You know, like a Rorschach, the psychologist test. Well, here, if you listen to my daughter, she explains it later on in the same movie. If you switch on the projector, you can see how he actually makes these designs.
Thank you.
sometimes we can start off a design by making an ink blot. Here, my brother will show you how it's done. He makes a little puddle of dye in the center of the paper. Now, by folding the paper over on it, he gets an ink blot design. See? Papa calls this the roar shot. Near the end of the session, my grandfather takes up all the brushes at once. Instead of cleaning them right away, he makes a big smear. Sometimes the result is horrible, but when he does it, I must admit, it usually does look good.
You can see how the little kid was trying to do like her grandfather by putting a whole bundle in her hand. Well, this gets back to what we were talking about, that you can learn from your own family.